Hey guys! Today I'm gonna be comparing and testing the Derwent Artist Pencils versus the Prismacolor Softcore Premier Pencils. The Derwent pencils I'm gonna be testing are in Light Violet, Chinese White, Mother Carmine, Magenta, and Ivory Black. And the Prismacolor ones are White, Blue, Violet, Black, and Red. I'm gonna start by making color swatches of the Derwent pencils, starting with magenta. Right off the bat, I can see that the Derwent pencils leave a very powdery cast. The pencils feel very dry and gritty, probably because they are wax-based. As you can see, the chalkiness is most noticeable in the black and white pencils. I'm gonna quickly swatch the Prismacolors right below. These are obviously not exact color dupes, except for the white. What I want to test here is the quality of the pencil itself. As you can see, the Prismacolor did not left any type of powdery cast. They felt very smooth and soft. And you can already see how pigmented and intense these are compared to the ones above. Number one, the Derwent pencils are not as pigmented and intense in color, while the Prismacolors deliver a lot of pigment even when I'm not pressing the pencil at all. Number two, the Derwent pencils go on patchy when I'm trying to layer the same color, while the Prismacolor has a smooth, opaque, effortless coverage. Number three, Derwent pencils are very dry and powdery. In fact, I had to press the Derwent pencil so hard that it scratched my paper. And like I mentioned before, the Prismacolor is soft and smooth. By the way, guys, look at Chihuahua. Say hi. Number four. Here I'm gonna be blending the light violet from Derwent with the Chinese white pencil on top. And for the Prismacolor version, I'm gonna be doing it with the violet and the white on top. As you can see, the Derwent side looks very patchy and streaky, while the Prismacolor side looks like an actual new color, and that's what we want. We want it to blend so good that we can actually create our own custom colors. In this little swatch, I actually used the magenta pencil from Derwent and attempted to blend it with my white Prismacolor pencil. And that doesn't look as bad, so maybe you can actually combine both pencils to have a better result. I am now going to be testing the Derwent pencils on this cat. I always start sketching the outline with a white charcoal pencil, but the rest of the pencils that I am using on this piece are the Derwent ones, specifically the Chinese white, the light lavender, and the ivory black. Oh, and I also use the magenta for the flowers. I am also adding details with my favorite jelly roll pens. And let's go to point number five, the price point. So I checked both Derwent and Prismacolor cases of 72 pencils, and the Derwent one has a price of 55.05, and the Prismacolor one has a price of 33.84. So you do the math. When I finished this piece, I felt like the Prismacolor pencils give me more control when I'm trying to draw my black paper art pieces. With the Derwent pencils, I feel like I felt a lot of strain on my hand because I was trying to make the colors so opaque and smooth, and those are not the qualities of these pencils in particular. Number 6. The Derwent pencils are larger in diameter than the Prismacolor ones. And the final point of this battle is number 7. Due to the soft core of the Prismacolor pencils, the wood tends to break a lot when you use a sharpener. However, to avoid this, you can use a knife to sharpen your pencils. Meanwhile, the wood in the Derwent pencils can withstand any sharpener due to the wax base in them. So there you have it. Let's have a look at the final verdict. I hope that with this video you can make an informed decision the next time you are buying art supplies. Don't forget to give me a like and subscribe to my channel for more. Until then, I will see you next week. Take care and bye bye!